Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today. So today I thought I'd do a little haul slash unboxing for you guys. I got a lot of cute spring stuff. I was in Toronto recently. I always debate whether I want to do an unboxing when it comes to a big thing like a Louis Vuitton or something like that, because I don't want to seem showy in any way. I bought this with another job I have, not YouTube, so I don't know why I say that. Maybe it makes me feel better. When I go in to buy a big ticket item, shoes, bag, whatever it may be, I kind of have in my head an idea of what I want to spend, what I want to buy, and that's it. It's one and done. I go in, I tell them what I want, I get it, I leave. I feel like I'm really short here. So, there, that makes me feel better. Okay, what am I talking about? So, yeah, I mean, I don't know what I'm saying. The point is, if you're looking for a bag or anything, you can kind of come on here and see what it's like. So when you go in, you kind of have some idea of what you want to spend and get. So I'm just going to jump right into it because I'm going to show this first for those of you that wanted to see it. And just that. Here it is. Beautiful orange and blue. Kind of reminds me of the Hermes. I don't know why it's this color. Maybe it's for spring, maybe it's for Easter. Every time I've gone in there, I've gotten dark brown bags, and I've never gotten a box. Okay, so I went in, I wanted to get the ballerina color, which means the light pink inside, and it was the blue and white and the outside checkered bag, shoulder bag, one shoulder, and I wanted to get the MM. So I basically went in and asked them, you have this bag, and let's see here. Comes with this nice, beautiful little receipt. I keep everything, the bags, the boxes, everything. If you're in the Toronto area, I highly recommend you work with Cynthia. I don't know if I'm pronouncing her name right. Miglio. She's great. She's awesome. She helps me all the time. So she's really sweet. I want to get the name right on the bag. So yeah. I am American. I bought it in Canada. The bag originally retails for $15.90. With tax, you're looking at $17.90. And it's the delightful PM Azure. Am I saying that right? Okay, I didn't know what I was saying. Demier, I didn't know. But I knew I wanted the delightful MM. So she got me the PM, which is the smaller bag, because to be honest, the MM was a lot bigger than I thought. I had a picture of it on my phone, and I basically just showed her what I wanted. So here we go. Literally an unboxing. Like, what could I use this for? I put that around my neck. So it's this really nice box, and like I said, I've never gotten a box in all the times I bought in Louis Vuitton bags. So magnetic closure, it opens up. Whoop. Okay, and then you have this, and I think the thing that I like about Louis Vuitton, obviously it's the quality, but the bags are always bigger than what you think. And yes, you're paying so much, but they really are. I mean, so this is the bag I got. Really happy with it. Has this, if you wanted, like a little, you could put a pom-pom on here, a keychain, whatever. I just wanted a straight up purse, okay? I didn't want a huge clutch, so really nice on the inside, that beautiful pink. This is really like what I wanted. I'm not a clutch girl. I need something bigger than that, but the PM actually was a lot bigger than what I imagined. So the MM was almost the size of my Neverfull, and let me show you the Neverfull. Hold on. It is so durable. I carry it with me everywhere. If you were gonna get one, I would suggest the Neverfull. Louis Vuitton has my initials on it, but let me just show you size wise I don't even know if you'll be able to see, but to compare, Neverfull, and this is the PM. The Neverfull is awesome, but it's literally, it's a travel bag. I'm lazy, so I don't switch it when I should. You can cinch the size and make it smaller, but it is a huge bag, so I fit more. So literally my arm kills me as I'm walking through the city with like a suitcase. So yeah, I mean, so I like this one. I fell in love with the pink. That's what I wanted the most. And I just thought it'd be really cute just to have a shoulder bag. Have not used this yet, so I will use this today, but usually when I'm traveling with the Louis Vuitton Neverfull, I will put a clutch or a smaller bag in there, and in that bag I will put my wallet, which will have my ID if I'm traveling to another country, and I have a separate container for my passport. I'll put my passport in there. Sunglasses, cell phone recharger, and like the lip gloss I'm using, whatever. Just like my most important things I will put in a smaller bag within that Neverfull, because it is the bottomless pit. I think the bowler bag and the Neverfull are kind of on par with that. I had the Louis Vuitton bowler that I sold to purchase this one. And I sold it to a family friend, so I don't have a trusty website for you to go to. But basically, what are my thoughts on that? They're just bottomless pits. And I know this will be too, but it's a little bit smaller, so you're fitting less and you can just grab it. You've got all your stuff in it. I thought it was so cute. So I purchased this, like I said, in Canadian, it was $1,700. I paid $1,300 because we do have that exchange. So it's worth it if you're going to go get a bag of this quality at this price, if you're American, to go somewhere like Canada for that exchange. I mean, or you don't have to, whatever you want to do. Okay, let's get into the other stuff. So bottom line is I love that bag. I highly recommend it. And I just thought, you know, if you were looking for one, you would now know kind of that whole thing. Okay, so where is... Oh, did I probably put them in that never-ending bag? Okay, well, I went to H&M. The only things that I got on there, and the reason I'm even showing these to you, I got this ring, which I thought was really cute. And I got these really trendy, which I think you would like, earrings that I think I threw in my bottomless pit here. But it really does carry everything. I mean, I love it. It's great for travel as your carry-on. Or whatever. Oh my god, what did I do with those earrings, you guys? Oh, here. These. I have wanted, like, cross earrings forever. I've been looking for them all over. Could not find them. These are, it's black, obviously. But, I'll probably paint this with clear nail polish so nothing falls off. But, you know, my hair is black, so I was kind of like, I don't know if I want, you know, I want it to stand out more. So I was looking at these white ones that I just love, but they were like from this website that was not very reliable. So let me put them on for you. I love them. But again, this was H&M, and they only had like one pair left. So I don't know, but I find H&Ms in bigger cities just have a better selection. I really go in there just for jewelry. Getting my hair color today, it's like a dark brown. I think I'm going to just go like that natural black I used to have. I haven't gotten it colored in forever, and I'm a little nervous to go. Tell me if you guys are like this. I can't say no to cutting my hair, and I don't want it trimmed. I don't want it cut. I do the micro trimming myself, and maybe it's not good. Maybe I'm not doing the right thing. I don't really care. I want to grow it long, and every time I get it trimmed, I know it's healthier. All you hairstylists out there that are cringing when I talk right now, but the problem is it just stays the same length, and it has for years, and I was just done with it. For the last year, I haven't cut it at all, and I've been growing it out 4 years, but I really wasn't because I was still getting it trimmed an inch, inch and a half each time to 2 inches at the most because it was so damaged. So I've cut back on coloring my hair, and I'm just growing it, and I've used oils. My advice to people who want to grow your hair is just grow it. Don't cut it. Do micro trimming. Whatever. Okay. Also at H&M, I did buy at a different H&M, I think it was on Queen Street, I bought this sweater. They were having a huge sale. I think it was $10. It's like a nice grandpa sweater, okay? It is so comfortable. Just love it. These pants I got, they are from Brandy and Melville. Absolutely amazing. They're really long. Okay, so, yeah, I'm going to jump all over the place, as you know. Okay. Zara takes all my money. Not even going to play with you. And they have a baby Zara in Toronto. So my brother is having twins. I know I put on Instagram a photo of moccasins that I bought because I wanted you guys to see them. I love Freshly Picked. It's a great company. It's over expensive, I know, but I overdid with the I got marble rose gold. Check out my Instagram, Danielle Marie Lifestyle. Go look at them, you guys. They're so bougie. But I love them. They're so cute. And then camo ones. But anyway, they had a Zara baby, and if I have a child ever, I feel like they will wear all fedoras and Zara Baby. They're so cute. So I got these pants. I'll tell you the prices if you want to know. They were $15, 3 to 6 months. Oh my God, it's a boy and a girl. So I got to go with that. I wanted to buy a fedora, did I buy that? I don't think I got that. But when I do, because you know I'll be going back in August, I will show it to you. This one was $7.90, and it is, again, 3 to 6 months. Just really comfortable casual tee that I thought would go with the pants. So, show you this cute little outfit. I don't know if you can see it. Really cute. They just have such comfortable, like, cute clothes. And I love Zara. It's my favorite store in the whole world. I'm not even kidding you. Then, these are obviously going to be, you know, this is for next summer, but oh my God, this was $19.90. Oh, it's so cute. Like, this is something I would wear. It was like shopping for myself, and I don't even like, I'm not like a true kid person. Although, yes, I work with kids and I'm around kids all the time. I don't know what's wrong with me, but it's such cute stuff. And then my mom got a little outfit too, these little pink jeans, like straight leg baby jeans. Are you for real right now? What is this? And then this cute, of course you're all going to go nuts over this, check this out. And this was, $12. I don't know if you can get Baby Zara online, I'm sure you can. Little baby unicorn, hot damn, look at how cute that is. And the pink baby jeans were $19.90. I don't know if I told you that, but like, look at the butt. Oh my God, so cute. And then we found this. We wanted a little boy one, but they only had the girls. This one was $12. So he got a fedora, but I don't have that. So then these little shorts, they are $15. Okay. And then cute little shirt to go with it. I feel like my boob is just going to be hanging out this whole video. I'm sorry if you see it. It's one of those days. $9.90. Okay, $9.90. Cute, right? Right? Like a little hospital gift. And it's, you know, they're for next year. So I went to Target, and Target had buy one, get one on shoes. So I purchased these sandals. I thought they were super cute. Little tassels and beading on them, just very bohemian. And they're really cute on. I shared them on Instagram. So for those of you that, you know, just go to my Instagram to see stuff or, you know, things in more detail, I take pictures and put everything on there because I don't have my blog product testing videos anymore, by the way. So, yeah. Okay. And this is Massimo. Is it Massimo? Mossimo? Mossimo? Massimo? I need a glass of wine. I don't even know. Okay. This and these ones, just like plain, I think, brown sandals. I went through my sandals and I never do this. And I just threw them all away. I have sandals I don't wear, I never wear, aren't my same size. I have sandals from high school in there. I just never went through my sandals. I had to go through and get rid of them. If I don't wear them, they're going to the garbage. If they're destroyed, if they're ripped, they're going to sandal heaven. I've seen everybody wear these on Instagram and on YouTube videos. So again, these are Massimo. And I really like the tan ones, but I decided to get white. I thought they were totally different. They have three little, you know, things where they can be, you know, onto your ankles there. Just thought they were really cute. I'm sorry, this is so awkward on how to hold them, but I don't want to. I get a ton of questions on these. I wore them all through Toronto. They were so comfortable. $15, Urban Outfitters. So I have the pink, and I also have an all black pair, which if you want to see, they're on my Instagram. They're downstairs, and I just don't feel like running down there right now. But, so comfortable, very lightweight. They have a spongy felt band here, so the fur isn't laying against your feet. So if you're worried about them making you hot, they won't. Probably won't last you more than like 2 to 3 seasons, depending on how long your summers are. But they're so soft, they're so cute. What I love about them is the thick band. I love that it's just very fluffy, very furry. A lot that I've seen don't look as aesthetically pleasing to me. They either look cheap or look fake or whatever. I know they're not Puma. I don't really care to spend that on something that trendy, in my opinion, but if you can, and you do you, girl or boy. So yeah, really cute. I love them. Again, $15 at Urban Outfitters. I bought 2 pairs. I get a ton of questions on those. The all black pair is super cute too, and they're so comfortable and lightweight. My mom got a pair at Zara, and they're more of a Birkin the flip-flop part and the furry part is like a teal green. It's really, really furry and in your face, but they're so cute. Those are $50. So if you have a Zara around you, you can check it there. Then I purchased these. I saw a girl wearing these on a blog, and these are Sam and Libby. I got them in a 7.5. These are 32, and the flip-flops, by the way, were all $15, but it was buy one, get one free. Just so you know, if you're, in case you're wondering, they were, you know, between like $13 and $15. So these ones here are 32, and they kind of reminded me a little bit of a Tory Burch. They have that tiki vibe. They have a shorter heel, which is nice. I thought you could wear them to work. You can wear them out. If you're doing a lot of walking and you're in a city or whatever, and you don't want those high stiletto heels, which sometimes we really just don't, even though they're gorgeous on. So very, very comfortable and very, very springy. A girl wore these. She had on like tight jeans, like rolled up once or twice, these heels, and like a cute little like Louis Vuitton bag, like I showed you. And just the picture was very aesthetically pleasing. I like that word today, right? So I thought they were really cute. And yeah, trying to look in the mirror behind me to make sure you guys can see these. Again, I took a picture and put them on Instagram. Last but not least, I had a pair of black knee-high boots that go a little bit above your knee. They had a really high heel and a huge platform here, extra platform here, which I hate. Had to get rid of them because I fell in them like several times, and if I can't wear them and I can't walk in them, I'm not gonna have them. But everybody needs over-the-knee pair of black boots, right? I mean, they're still popular, so got these from Target. The heel looks longer than it really is. It's just, it's not uncomfortable. I'm not tripping or falling. What's nice about this is it's a very padded, felt-like comfort up here. These aren't tight to your leg. You can adjust them, so you can make them tighter. You can make them wider. If you're a wider leg calf type of girl, I think that you would love these because there's a lot of give and take to them. So they go just over the knee. And like I said, I like that it has the string. Some don't, like the ones that I got rid of. And those are only going to last you a season, maybe two. All these won't last you very long, but they start to slouch down, you know, and that's really annoying. So bought these. They're really comfortable, and there's a lot of give in them. There's a lot of room. So don't feel like, oh, I could never wear those because I don't think they fit my calf. Try them. The brand was Journey. And I don't think it's Journeys, like the Journeys shoe store, but that was the name of them if you want to find it on Target. Then I purchased this. This is so random, but it's, I guess, a beauty thing. This is the Remington Dual Blade, and it's supposed to be for any kind of facial hair that you want to get rid of. There's dual blades, pivoting head, detail light, reveals fine hairs for easier removal, and this got so many good stars. The one I wanted, they were all sold out of. Let me know if you guys have ever used anything like this and what you think of it. So, perfect for eyebrow shaping, it says. Precision. Does take precision hair removal. AAA battery, which is included. Number one hair removal for women. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. Alright, so sticking with Zara, these shoes were $25. It was a deal. I had to get them, and I don't have any silver shoes, shockingly enough. So got these in a 7.5, and they're that, you know, oh-so-famous, transparent, and, you know, color type of shoe. Nice heel to them. They're really, really cute on. They're really sharp. Now, I don't particularly like Zara denim. I tried it on. It fits me weird. It makes me look weird. I feel like I'm an odd shape. I really don't have much of a waist or a top. I do have a butt. I do have a little bit of a thigh, so, but then I have very skinny, like where my mid-thigh is down, very skinny legs. I don't know, I just, that makes me look, feel like a pelican, kind of, not pelican, flamingo, I don't know. But I saw these, and I needed a pair of denim shorts, so, and I was just looking for a regular pair of denim, but these look just, they looked huge, first of all, to me, and I was like, oh, I don't know. I tried them on, and I love them. They are the like high-waisted, like, you know, the mom jeans, the high-waisted, I don't know how to say it, high-waisted jean short, but wearing like a longer top over it that cuts like right here in the middle, they just look so nice. I love the longer fringe. Okay, I love the longer fringe. I loved kind of the ripped tier detail. And these are a size 4. I did size up because when they go high-waisted, I don't like anything cutting into my stomach. So they were a little big in the back for me. But they fit fine. There's so many buttons that they're not going to fall down on me. I just, you know, the 2 would have fit fine too, but I like a little more give and take. You just never know, you know? So, and it made them a little bit longer, but I love the length. I loved the fringe. They were so cute. And I don't, like I said, I don't love, it's the Trafalook. No, they were $35. Am I saying that right? So, the 2 fit just fine too. Again, this was a little bit bigger in the back for me, but it's fine. I like to size up if nothing else, so I can just feel that comfort. If you're going on a long car ride or you're throwing them on the beach and, you know, I don't know, when you hit like 30, the tight clothing just, it's gotta have some give and take. Very Coachella, very festival. Just love them. This was on sale at Zara too. It was $25. Reminded me a lot of Chanel. Say kind of a clutch. I like the bigger clutches. This is the nice, and it has this kind of threading detail all throughout the bag. I just thought it was great. So, nice and big. It's not a small clutch, so you really can fit enough. Like, this is something I would take and put in my Neverfull and put my wallet and everything in it. These bags, I think, just look so classy on when you've got even just like a casual outfit. They go with any kind of outfit or really dressing it up. I always think that there, it's got this fringe here. So gorgeous. Just a beautiful, beautiful bag. I loved it. Zara has got great bags. Whew! I purchased these. These were $35 and they're small and they're from Zara, and it's just a pair of pink, really relaxed fit material clothing, pants. I love these. I have a couple pairs from Zara. They make wonderful, wonderful pants. Really comfortable. They're great to wear to work. They're great to dress up and go to dinner in. Any kind of top. Really cute. I purchased this. I have a top that's blue and white striped from Zara. This, though, just like grabbed my attention. First of all, it was small. It's a small and it was $69. And just look at the sleeves and you'll know why. Hopefully you can see those. Right? Oh my god. And then it had, it's like I said, it's a jacket. You can wear it over anything. It has these tassels. Really cute with those like tiki shoes I showed you from Zara. And the embroidering is also on the other sleeve. I fell in love with it. And this blue and white striped is all over Zara. It's all over. Zara has, so I just thought it was great. And I wore this. I took pictures. I put it on my Instagram when we were at dinner there, so you can check it out to see how it looks on. And you really can wear that with anything. You really can. So, Brandy Melville, I told you I got the pants I'm wearing, and then this hoodie, just a pink sweatshirt, oversized, loved it. I was freezing when we were there. It was supposed to be 70, but the first day it was very cold, so I picked up a sweatshirt. Brandy Melville has really cute, like Newport Beach, Malibu, USA theme right now. Very Cape Cod summer in there. I was not going to purchase these, but I did. I'm not even sorry. These were 50, right? I think, yeah. Size 7.5. Oh my god. These are another, the Miu Miu trend. Flip-flops. Look at these. They're really cute on and they're really comfortable. They're very thin, but I mean, they're great. Wear them to work. Wear them out. It's a conversation piece for sure. And I thought they were really cute. Got these for Brandy Melville. They're just one size sweatpants. And they're like the sweatpants you wore like as a kid, right? With this. And they have like that tighter ankle part there. Really comfortable. Wore these on the car ride home. BCBG. I don't know why I want to call it like something it's not, was having a huge sale. This was like $14. Like everything they were getting rid of. I don't know why, but this was a little cute sundress and just white silk. But look at the bottom. Can you see that? just thought it was really pretty detailing. Really cute for the summer. Just to go out to dinner again, wearing with these that I've been showing you. I think all this stuff would be cute with these shoes. Okay. The reason I went into Zara too was to get a kimono. Ever since I saw Beyonce wearing one. So this one was, again, it's that Trafalook. Trafalook, it must be like a brand within Zara or something, or I'm just a complete idiot. I got this in a small. It was $69. Of course, everything in Zara is $50 or $69 or $29, right? If you're a Zara person, you know what I'm saying. Just beautiful. Like, it's long, beautiful orange and white, kind of cape sleeves. I just thought it was perfect. And you guys, this is the kind of stuff you can wear anywhere. Goes down about mid-calf. Okay. So, yeah. Love it. I purchased some, just kind of, I needed, like, tank tops or just basic tees and things like that. So, this is, again, these were all, like, $7. No, this was $19. This is a small. And it was just a tank top. Just a black V-neck long tank top. To wear with leggings, just to wear to travel in. I just, you know those basic tees that you're always like, I'm looking for a white tank top to wear in or something, or a white t-shirt. I feel like that's me every day. This was the $7, yeah. And this is, I get it in a little oversized. I got it in a medium. Again, this is from Zara, just tank top. You could wear a cute little bralette under it. Wear it under, you know, a revealing shirt or something, whatever. And I got it in white. Then I purchased this because I thought it was so cute in a medium, and this is $15 from Zara. It says caution, has a mermaid. Okay. I thought this would be cute. This was on sale. It was like $15, right? $15 or $20, yeah. It's a small, and it's just an orange, like, tank top dress. They had a whole bunch, like, little ruffled ones. They are so cute. Form-fitting. Yet relaxed, goes about, again, mid-calf. I thought it'd be cute under that kimono, even under that blue and white striped jacket with those embroidered sleeves I showed you. This dress I got too, from Zara. Oh, I just thought it was so cute. We don't have a Zara where I live, by the way, so when you see me stocking up, it's like once a year, if that. This is $69. Did I get it in a medium? Oh, yeah, because there were no smalls. It's like an off-the-shoulder, though. It reminded me of, like, a little dress you'd see, like, someone wearing in some bar in Mexico. I don't even know why I'm saying that, but so cute for the summer. I got rid of a lot of my dresses and maxis just because they were falling apart. They were so old, you know, holes in them, things like that. So cute little belt. Just really, really sweet. From Zara. It was $7, just a camo t-shirt. I always really wanted one of these. I don't know why. Very light, very airy, very, very comfortable. So, yeah, so that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this unboxing and you enjoyed some of these things that I showed you. I'd love to hear about new places that you're shopping or trips you've taken over this spring break or anything you're doing for Easter. And any questions you have about my bag or anything, just leave it below. The straps are not adjustable, just so you know, in case that's a question, but this is it here, full of all my stuff. And yeah, I will talk to you later. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a wonderful Easter if you celebrate it, and I will see you next time. Bye.